This is our second video of the series, The Chemical Basis of Life. In this video, we will talk about water, its properties, and its function in cells. Let us start with the basic properties of water. Water molecules have one big oxygen atom hanging out at one end and two smaller hydrogen atoms at the other. So, it doesn't look the same on both sides. This is what we call asymmetric. Water is formed by a covalent bond between an oxygen atom and two hydrogen atoms. This connection does not share the electrons equally. The oxygen side tends to hog electrons more, making it a bit negative, while the hydrogen side becomes a bit positive. So, water ends up being like a tiny magnet with a positive side and a negative side. This is what we mean when we say water is a polar molecule, like a tiny magnet with two different ends. Because of this, water molecules can attract or stick to each other and other molecules, especially ones that also have positive and negative parts, by forming hydrogen bonds. In fact, all three atoms in a water molecule can form hydrogen bonds. These hydrogen atoms in one water molecule can join hands with the oxygen atom in another water molecule or other molecules. These characteristics lead to a highly interconnected network of water molecules, with each water molecule capable of forming hydrogen bonds with up to four others. These bonds contribute towards the strong adhesion property of water due to extensive hydrogen bonding. Another crucial property of water is its thermal properties and its ability to regulate the temperature in cells. Water has a high specific heat capacity, which means it can absorb and store a significant amount of heat without a large increase in temperature. Water also has good thermal conductivity, which means it distributes temperature uniformly in the system. Now let us discover how these properties function together in the biological system in cells. 1. Universal solvent. Because of its polarity and ability to form an extensive number of hydrogen bonds, water is an excellent solvent for a wide range of substances such as proteins, nucleic acids, ions, and carbohydrates. 2. Medium for biochemical reactions. Water serves as a medium for biochemical interactions due to its unique properties. As a polar molecule, water can dissolve and surround other polar or charged molecules, facilitating their interactions. Water's ability to form hydrogen bonds is also significant. This allows water molecules to interact with functional groups on biomolecules, influencing their structure and facilitating biochemical reactions. 3. Chemical reactant. Water is not only a medium for biochemical interactions. It also participates directly in various chemical reactions. For instance, it is involved in hydrolysis reactions where large molecules are broken down into smaller components by the addition of water molecules. 4. Hydration and structure. Water plays a crucial role in shaping the structure of biomolecules, like proteins and DNA, in living organisms. This is because of its polarity and ability to form hydrogen bonds, in addition to its ability to regulate temperature, which is crucial for maintaining the shape and structure of biomolecules, preventing them from getting messed up when the temperature changes. 5. Temperature regulation. In the context of cells, because water has a high specific heat capacity, it helps to resist changes in temperature. Also, it absorbs heat generated by biochemical processes, such as metabolism and chemical reactions in cells. It prevents heat concentration and contributes to temperature balance in the cell due to its thermal conductivity. Another point is water is able to release heat through the process of evaporation. As cells lose water through processes like transpiration, in plants, or sweating, in animals, the evaporation of water takes away heat energy, cooling the cell and helping to maintain a stable internal temperature. 6. Transport medium. Water serves as a transport medium within cells and throughout organisms. Substances like nutrients, ions, and waste products move within and between cells through aqueous solutions, enabling essential processes like nutrient uptake and waste elimination. 7. Transparent medium. Due to the covalent bond, water molecules are considered a tiny magnet. These magnets have a positive and a negative end. When light goes through water, these tiny magnets don't hold on to the light too much because the light isn't strong enough. In other words, the energy levels associated with visible light are not high enough to cause significant changes in the water molecules, like breaking bonds or moving electrons to higher energy states. This was everything for this video. Thank you for watching.